lots to talk about across all markets, things moving everywhere, and that includes lean hogs. We talked about lean hogs a lot last year, and actually the year before as well, because they were right in the middle of the tariff tantrum we had with China. But it's all about China again, a little bit different this time around with the coronavirus, COVID-19, and how that's affecting these prices. So let's firstly state off that, you know, we did have some news, some negative news, that some packers aren't taking any more animals, and that's due to the fact that the virus, it's got staff levels are down, so there's nobody there to work. That's an issue across all businesses, but again, this is not immune to that. So that was probably a little bit of negative news there, but it just doesn't matter because it's the demand news that's really kind of taken hold here. So, and that demand news is going to be, look, on the back of the fact that we've seen a horrific fall in prices from 82 down to say 38, which is over a 50%, you know, move, 54% actually. These two moves the last few days aren't unexpected, and it's good to see things going in the right direction. We had news over the weekend. Our Surgeon General out talking about where our 9/11 is going to be this week, or our Pearl Harbor and 9/11 is going to be this week. That had a lot of folks in the investing community, worried about what might be coming around the corner. And as we've woken up here in the second day, so we're 40% through the week, it doesn't look to be as bad as maybe if things were made out to be, or at least that there is some side of a sense of hope or of things getting better. And that's got equities just ripping your face off higher. And it's also got this market, again, limit up. So that's going to be something with that pent-up demand and everybody staying at home. I think that this market's reacting to the same things, but in a slightly different manner, the same things that some of these equity markets are also reacting to. And interesting to note, on top of all that, that great demand news, but you know, the funds are still long 30,000 contracts. That's a decent chunk. So maybe, just maybe, they knew something and they had a reason to hang on here, and they're still long them. So keep that in mind. That's something also that you kind of like to see. But at the end of the day, I think this is really large partly due to the fact that, look, there's this demand that's been pent up and things looking better in the light at the end of the tunnel. They kind of all lead to green arrows higher today.